Good afternoon, Miss Anna May.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Okay, Miss Anna May, can you tell me about yourself?
Ma'am, I'm Anna May Fama, 16 years old. I'm from Sabo Branch and I'm college undergraduate.
Okay, I have a few questions for you to answer. So let's start. Why do you want to work as a maid? Why you choose Malaysia when there is a lot of other country? Okay, how are you qualified for this job?
Because I'm a hardworking person,
Okay. May I know what is your education level is?
Second year college, ma'am.
Okay. So you mean are you college undergraduate or college level?
College level.
Okay. What is your recent working experience? Do you have any work experience? Okay. Have you worked abroad before?
No, ma'am.
Do you have experience of taking care of baby?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and whose baby you are taking care of?
My own baby.
How about elderly? Do you have experience that you take care before?
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. So whose elderly you take care?
My grandfather, ma'am.
How old is your grandfather when you take care of him?
81 years old, ma'am.
81 years old, okay. Do you have any other special skills?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can you give me an example? What are those special skills do you have?
Cleaning, dishwashing, baby sitting, and taking care of elderly persons.
Okay. Are you willing to learn new skills?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you willing to work with a family where the mother-in-law or any relatives stay together?
Yes, ma'am.
Currently, are you still working now?
No,
do you know how to cook?
Yes, ma'am.
What sort of food can you cook?
Filipino food, ma'am.
Okay, can you give me an example? What are those Filipino food that you can cook?
Adobo, ma'am, tinola, and sinigang.
Okay. Are you aware that you will have to do washing, cleaning, ironing, and cooking?
Yes, ma'am.
From all the house chores like cooking, cleaning, ironing, and washing, which do you like most?
Cleaning, washing, and...
Okay. If ever you were selected to work in Malaysia, who will take care of your kid?
My husband, ma'am.
You are not allowed to use handphone or cell phone during working hours. You are only allowed to use handphone or cell phone after you finish all the works and when going to bed. You are strictly needed to surrender the handphone to your employer in the morning, and your employer will return back to you once you're going to bed. If ever your employer finds out that you're abusing your handphone and it's affected your work performance, your employer will confiscate your handphone and you're not allowed to hold it anymore. Instead, your employer will allow you to call to your family 3 times in a month. You're only allowed to bring normal phone and you're not allowed to bring smartphone. Are you agreed for the terms and condition?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you agreed to the rules and regulation for the handphone?
Yes, ma'am.
How many years is the contract you agreed and understand?
2 years contract, ma'am.
Can you describe for me your ethics or your attitude? Okay. Can you please repeat again? Can you describe for me your ethics or your attitude? Okay. How can you assure to us that you will work hard in Malaysia? What will you do? Okay, you want to support your family or especially your kids. So what will you do while you are working here in Malaysia? What will you do?
I will work hard.
You will work hard, okay. Can you promise not to use the telephone permission of your employer? Can you promise?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you promise not to put on makeup but to dress properly while work?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you promise not to invite friends and relatives without the consent of your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you promise not to ask for advance salary from your employer under any circumstances?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you really understand of the rules and regulation of the agency?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you pay any placement fee for you to come to Malaysia to work as a maid?
No, ma'am.
Do you have any history of sickness, example breast cancer or any other illness?
No, ma'am.
Do you suffer from any skin diseases, allergy or physical defect?
No, ma'am.
Have you suffered from any serious illness?
No, ma'am.
Do you smoke?
No, ma'am.
Do you have any tattoo in the body? Miss Anna May? Do you have any tattoo in the body? Okay. Do you take any prohibited drugs before? Miss Anna May, can you please repeat your answer? Do you take any prohibited drugs before? Have you undergone any operation or surgery? Miss Anna May, can you again repeat your answer? Okay. Have you undergone any operation or surgery?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, what type of operation you underwent before?
Cesarean.
Okay. May I know what month, what year was that?
December 2011.
Okay. Are you medically fit? Are you fit to work?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you in any medication?
No, ma'am.
Are you allergic with any food?
No, ma'am.
Are you prepared to work for the employer of any race?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you prepared to eat the type of food taken or given by your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you afraid of being left alone in the house?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Are you afraid of dogs or other pets?
No, ma'am.
Can you promise to work according to instruction from your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any immediate family working in Malaysia?
No, ma'am.
Okay, Miss Anna May, we have finished our question section. Let's go to case study. I have a case study for you and I want you to answer me truthfully. Upon arrival in Malaysia within 6 months, if ever any of your family members pass away, what will you do? Will you continue to work till finish your contract or you will go back?
Ma'am, I will continue my work until I finish my contract.
Okay, tell us about yourself and why do you want to work in Malaysia as domestic helper?
Ma'am, I'm a maid and I'm a hardworking person and I really want to work as a maid with my family.
Okay, Miss Anna May, what do you want to tell to your employer who's watching your video?
Ma'am, this is me because I'm a hardworking person, kind, polite, and respectful. I want to work as myself because I want to be supported by my family.
Okay, thank you very much, Miss Anna May. We will update your agency if there's any selection made to the employer.
Thank you, ma'am.